Welcome to video number 26, Introduction to Panel Data, Part 2. In this video, I am going to discuss fixed effect model. And in the next video, I'll discuss random effect model and when to apply random effect model versus fixed effect model. So as we have seen in our previous video, when we apply fatality rate, we regress fatality rate on BA tax for 1982, or for 1988 separately, we get positive slope. It means that our this sign is not as per theory, but when we have taken the difference, this sign is as per economic theory. So you can watch the previous video. Fixed effect model, basically it means that we have some variables which vary across states, but they are unobserved, like culture, like driving culture, like eating culture. You cannot measure, but those variables otherwise affect your response variable. So how do we take care of this such issue? If you have data for more than two time periods, then you introduce basically n-1 dummy variables to capture state specific effects. So n-1 dummy variables are introduced because your intercept is already there. So to avoid dummy variable trap, you introduce n-1 binary variables. Now, for example, if you have three states, California, Massachusetts, Texas, for California, you have intercept beta naught plus beta 2. For Massachusetts, you will have beta naught plus beta 2, Massachusetts, and so on. So, we'll have this intercept different for each, but slope is same for each state. So, we introduce two dummies. You see intercept is varying, slope is beta naught. So we introduce two dummies here, California. So this is one if California, otherwise zero. This is one if Texas, otherwise zero. So when both are zero, it means beta naught, which means it's Massachusetts. So beta one is same for all, because we are trying to measure the effect of X on Y, holding the effect of other constant, but other variables are basically unobserved, so therefore we need to capture those state specific effects by introducing these dummy variables. So we have n-1 binary variables, fixed effect model, alpha I, basically this is gamma 2, d2 I is alpha I, alpha 1 I, alpha 2 I, and so on. So you need to introduce n-1 binary variables, which means if n is large, you have to introduce a large number of binary variables. Another approach to solve this problem is to use demeaned regression, entity demeaned or time demeaned, or entity and time demeaned regression. I'll talk in a short while. If you have two time periods, then you can use the third technique, which we have already applied. So let's go. You have D2 to Dn, n-1 binary variables. You can estimate by OLS. This is called least square dummy variable model. But in this case, if n is very large, you can lose lot of degree of freedom. You have to introduce a large number of dummy variables. If you have n equal to 10,000, you have to 9,999 dummy variables. So instead of that, we use entity demeaned regression. We take the average over time of all the variables, and then we subtract second one from the first one. So you will see that entity specific effects, which we assume that will not change over time, they will cancel from each other. They will cancel from each other, and only impact of X will be on Y. This is called entity demeaned, or instead of, we'll call average regression, and instead of regressing Y on X, we construct two variables, new variables, and this is called entity demeaned regression. You don't need to construct these variables at your own. You need to understand why do we do this. So this is first construct the demeaned. So you construct these two variables and then you regress, and instead it's simply AREG is the command, and you regress your fatality rate on BA tax. You absorb state, because I am not interested in 47 dummy variables. So my interest is only what is the effect of BA tax on fatality rate. So the basically AREG does it automatically for you, and in all softwares. I have done this in R as well, so you can watch it from there. You can download the document. Okay, state specific effects we are not interested. You see, when you have two time periods, it's minus 1.04, that is increasing beer tax by $1 per case, reduces death rate by 1 per 10,000, which is quite high, because total deaths are 2 per 10,000 in our data. So reducing 1 per 10,000 is quite high. This is slightly less, but you see, this is data for 7 time periods, whereas this is data only for 2 time periods. So there is a difference in data. Regression with time effects. There may be a case that your roads have improved over time, you have better cars, you have some other laws, so therefore there can be changes over time as well. So you can introduce time specific dummies as well. You can introduce state specific dummies or time specific dummies, or both state and time specific dummies. And in this case, you can go the same way. You have binary variables, so you have 82 to 88 data. So one dummy is less than total number of categories. So instead, you have 7 dummies. So your tax, beer tax coefficient remains more or less same, and it's significant as well. So you can have combined entity and state specific dummies. You can have T minus 1 indicators. You have N minus 1 indicators. Or you can have both T minus 1 and N minus 1 indicators. The fixed effect regression assumptions are more or less same as in least square model, but one more specific assumption, that is, we are going to introduce the first four we have already discussed time and again. UIT and UIS is zero, because previously in cross-sectional data we have only I, but today we have T as well. So you can have atherosclerosis, you can have autocorrelation. So what to do with this? So you have default standard errors, robust standard errors for cross-sectional data. Today I am going to talk about cluster standard errors. Cluster standard errors basically address the issue of cross-sectional as well as autocorrelated standard errors. I'll upload a short clip on robust standard, default, robust, clustered, and bootstrap standard errors in some other video. Okay, assumption 1 as usual, assumption 2 as usual, 5, assumption number 5, that is, this we haven't discussed so far throughout our course. So what enters the error term? So you have here autocorrelation problem as well as heteroscedastic problem. So your default standard errors will not work. Your states variables are correlated over time. Your classes may be independent. So it does not necessarily that there is correlation only over time. You have a you have classes which are your clusters. Classes are correlated within the classes, but they are independent of each other. So you can have this you see clustering over time as well as clustering across cross sections, but at the moment I am assuming that your states are correlated over time. So how is this? We use we don't need to drive this. We just go, and I'll explain you that you have today, instead of variant robust default or robust, you have clustered standard errors, which are slightly different than your routine standard errors. What's their theory? That's a topic for some other time. So we have clustered standard errors, or you can say heteroscedastic and autocorrelated consistent standard errors. I'll show you their use and how they affect results. So let's see. We have average regression, and we regress fertility rate on beer tax by using robust standard errors. So coefficient is minus 0.65 and standard error is 0.20. But when we use robust and clustered standard errors, so coefficient remains same, but this is different. So it means it's important to use the correct standard errors, because it may lead to different results. So same is the case here. You have slope coefficient same, but standard error is 0.25, but when you use clustered, it is 0.38. So In this case, you have four models. In two models, you have used cluster standard errors. In two models, you have not used. So you see this level of significance from model two, one to model two changes. This is 5%, this is 10%, and here it's one asterisk, here you have two. So therefore, this matters that whether you are using correct standard errors or not. Now we are going to apply, we are trying to find out whether BATX leads to reduction in traffic fatalities or not. So you have introduced some economic variables, some demographics, some legal variables. So you have mandatory punishment, minimum legal drinking age, economic interventions, policy variables. So you should need to have increase in economic intervention, increase in alcohol taxes or not. So you have 48 states, 7 years data, and these are the variables listed here. You can go to Stock and Watson website, and you can read more about these variables, explanation. So culture of driving, quality of roads, these are the variables which are very difficult to measure, but they can be state specific, they can be time specific, so we can control them using this panel data. So you have first model where your coefficient is 0.36, and you neither you have state specific nor time specific nor cluster standard errors. Some variables are in the next table as well, and in this case it's as per theory minus 0.66. You have used state specific effects in these two. In the model 4 you have basically yes and some other you see maybe next slide. Yes, you have time effects as well. So you have model 4, you can compare it, and you see as unemployment rate is negative and significant, which means, and real income per capita is positive and significant, which means that as unemployment goes up, you have traffic fatality accidents goes down. It's as per theory, income goes up, you'll drive more, you'll drink more, and all those things. And similarly, you have this these variables, important variables here, and you see what's the difference here. You have no cluster standard errors, no cluster standard errors, no cluster standard errors. Here you have cluster standard errors. So you see model 5, 4, 6 and 7 are very close match to each other. Some other variables you have also introduced here: drinking coefficient, jail, mandatory service effects, and income per capita equal to zero. So what we see that, one important thing. In this case, if you pick model 7, so you see you don't find effect of beer and so therefore this shows that you need further investigation before jumping to the conclusion that increase in beer tax will lead to lowering fatality rate. So you see we have 7 different models. These are called alternative specifications, and then we try to find out the pick the one which is the best, which is the best. So all these candidate model, these are candidate models, and we try to find out empirical analysis. You can read it from the book. Fixed effect are statistical significant but do not have big on the coefficients. We are not interested in individual coefficients, and this is again a summary which we have discussed already. So advantages and limitations of fixed control for unobserved variables that vary across states but not over time or vary over time. There will be loss of degree of freedom, which I'll discuss in my next video. Time lag effects are important, and that will lead to some other complications. At the moment, I am talking about micro panel, short panel, where you have more cross-sectional, large cross-sectional units and small time periods. We are now talking about time series. My next video will be about random effect model and random effect model versus a fixed effect model and Hausman test. And after that, I will do all this. I'll replicate this table using Stata. Thank you for watching. Take care.